Hi, everybody. Mr. Southerton here. Today, I'm going to try to do a text-dependent analysis paper with you and try to show you my thought process and how I approach this. The story today is actually an article from a newspaper. Really good friend of mine from back in the day, Kevin Edwards, wrote this article, and he wrote it about my uncle, Junie Rickard. And I think it's a really cool article, and I hope you enjoy it. And it's always nice, I think, to be able to make some sort of a connection when you do this stuff, especially when you're learning it. So it helped me to identify a few things, and I want to share it with you and share my thought process on how to do this TDA, text-dependent analysis, and share my screen to show you this. So here we go. I believe that's sharing now. As I look at this, it's called Clarence Junie, that's the name that he went by, Rickard, is a Wayne County legend. Here you can see Kevin Edwards wrote this January 15th, 2021 in the Tri-County Independent. Now, the best thing that we can do as readers approaching something like this, say on a PSSA test, is to look at the prompt first, any questions that might be there. We know about that, but we have to really think about it and analyze any other things that you can. So this says, throughout this article, the author, Kevin Edwards, developed a respect for Junie Rickard, the person, instead of just Junie Rickard, the hunter. Cite three examples from the text that show how and why Kevin Edwards had his eyes opened to Junie the person. Include an introduction, three body paragraphs with examples and explanations, and a conclusion. Five total paragraphs. So right now I'm thinking, yes, five total paragraphs is what I have to have, an intro, a conclusion, and maybe three different examples that show this. Now, as I go through, I can see a lot of people don't like this, but these templates really do help us organize our thoughts. This first box will contain my introduction. This second box, excuse me, will contain my second overall paragraph, but it will be the first body paragraph, and it has three different parts, but again, it's all contained within that. Again, these are just notes that I take down. I could scribble things out later. You'll see that. A third paragraph, second body paragraph. And I even have things on the other side there. I have it as a separate paper. Again, a body paragraph four, and then a concluding paragraph. So I might even want to take a good look at this even before I read it, because I can see, I analyze it, it's broken down into different sections. Local legend, farm family. So right now I'm already making some ideas and some inferences. So a local legend, farm, okay, farm family. So I'm guessing right now this guy, maybe he worked on a farm. Now, again, I know that because he's my uncle, but if he were a complete stranger, I'd be able to make these inferences even before I read, so I can prepare myself to maybe comprehend the material a lot more easily, and I can read with a purpose. I go down through this, and I see indefatigable. Now, fatigue, that means like you get tired, but this means that this guy, you know, it's a section that might show that he's rarely tired. He's always working. Again, I don't know that for sure yet, but I'm making those inferences. Again, I can see that this article is broken down into different sections. Moral of the story. Usually that means that, you know, maybe we learned something here. At the very bottom, this goes over to another page. It says, poignant reminder. And again, that does take us to a different page that will conclude everything for us. I do have some pictures I'm going to show you. Then I'm going to go to a different video to actually read this to you. So here are some photos of my Uncle Junie. Awesome guy. One of the nicest guys you could ever meet. Here he is on a tractor. Now I'm looking at this. So again, farming, I've already heard that. I heard something about hunting too, at least in the opening blurb there. I can see a dog that may or may not have something to do with this. Hopefully he's not like driving forward and he's about to run over the dog. I don't want that to happen. But anyway, he looks like he's enjoying life there. Here he is. Now, it did say something, like you said, in the opening about him being a hunter. So I can maybe make an inference here that this is going to be all about him hunting. Right? I could be wrong. I see somebody looking proudly in the back there. I don't know who that is. Well, I do. It's my cousin Jim. But anyway, if I were a stranger looking at this, I would try to put these pieces together even before reading. And there I see my cousin Tim, Tim's son Shane, and there's my Uncle Junie again, and they have two buck there and a bear. This, I can tell you, they were, again, three generations. They were out hunting, and this all happened in one day. So that was last year. But again, this was included with the newspaper article that Kevin Edwards put forth. So I haven't even begun reading yet. I've taken a good look, and I've already made an inference as to where this might go. Some of my things could be accurate. Some of the things might not be accurate, but at least I can approach this now and with a clear mind. So I'm going to stop the share here. Sorry about that. I know that I had a blank page showing there. So I am going to go to a part two video where I actually read this newspaper article. I'm going to show you maybe how I annotate or highlight and just take some things down. Okay. So signing out for this part one of Clarence Junie Rickard, and him being a Wayne County legend.